Hello, everyone, and welcome back to RollPlay Solum. It's week 35. I'm JP McDaniel. Made it in the nick of time, at least for the hype song. We're 8 minutes late, but no one's going to remember that because people are going to be watching on Twitch. Anyways, let's find... or on YouTube. Anyways, let's find out what the rest of the cast is up to. We'll go around the horn. Jeff, let's start with you, man. How you been?
A pretty uneventful week, I think, for Jeff. He's, well, just look at his face, man. He's had a rough week. That's all.
That's how fucking funny that is. I'm going to lose my shit, dude. He literally goes like this. He goes, and then he goes to talk. The webcam goes dead. In the 4 minutes of, like, constant rushing to build 8 scenes in Skype or in XSplit and everything is just met by Jeff disconnecting. And that is perfect. That is perfect. Let's find out what someone else said.
I think I need to change my picture for when I disconnect so that I get something like this.
Oh my god. Ryan, how about you? Don't disconnect. Be careful.
Okay, so this week
he's still here. Okay. How's it going, Jeff? Or not you. I'm in Ryan.
Okay, so this... it's actually been like 2 weeks since we played, so... notable things that I have done. I bought an Xbox, and you actually helped me set up my cap card, and I've been streaming some Halo.
There it is.
I did.
That timing, though.
Oh, it was... I lost my shit, but...
Oh, it was you.
No, it was you that I, like, lost it in terms of laughing.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. It was amazing.
You actually lost your shout-out time, and we killed your character in the time that you were gone, so...
That was...
It's
that
rough. We're getting cutthroat here at Roleplay.
I'm emotionally distraught right now. That was insane.
So you bought an Xbox One.
Yes, I bought an Xbox One. I've been streaming Halo, mostly old-school Halo 1. Okay. I've been growing this beard out, which, like... Okay, so this upcoming week...
Are we
going
to have a beard
week,
off?
No, sadly, we can't. This week, I'm going to my grandparents for Thanksgiving in Georgia, and I think I'm going to try and look presentable to them, and probably going to shave this guy off. But I think I'm going to shave it into a pretty sweet mustache and take some pics before I do, so.
Is that the only reason you grow your shit out? Just so you can make, like, stupid mustaches and
shave
things?
It into awesome things? That, and also, like, I don't really enjoy shaving.
You're
going to
be like, guys, I'm going to do a 24-hour stream. I guess I'll shave my beard for, I don't know, $3,000. It's
no,
going to suck.
That's hand turkey range, dude. You're way off on the milestones. You just don't even know.
Okay. All
right. Like,
so we're not seeing the return of the cattiness.
Three grand, I'll show you the interior of my car or something, like, sweet like that. You know,
wow.
It's not... Yeah. Just
the interior of your... That's okay, whatever.
It's worth it. It's
for
worth
just
it.
$3,000 though, JP. Like, that's actually not
think
that
about
big.
It. Yeah,
I mean,
pretty
good.
Like live picture.
I'd pay for that.
So anyway, yeah, I've been playing Halo. I have actually been following World of Warcraft streams, and like I feel the dark hand of the game wanting to pull
Mike
me back
Morhaime
in.
Slowly caressing your head.
Yes,
trying to get
yes.
You back in.
I feel it, man. Like, because they did all the old school stuff with WoW and, you know, the old, you know, like, it feels like Warcraft 2-ish and old school, not like really as much into the like futuristic stuff anymore. I really like that. So
yeah, yeah.
I'm thinking about it. Been playing a lot of League. They did a nice map update, so the game looks completely different now. A lot of changes, so I've been doing that too.
Cool.
And yeah.
So how like on a scale, because I love when people ask me this on stream, on a scale of 0 to 100 percentile, how close to you are coming back to WoW? Like, what would take that 100%?
Nice.
How do you commit? For nothing else to be released that really grabs my interest in the next week.
Ryan, it's Black Friday week. Nothing comes out after this week. Like,
yeah.
Or not Cars. Fuck, what is it? The Crew. Cars comes out on Tuesday, right?
Disney's The Cars.
I mean, I'm
no,
gonna
The
be
Crew comes out. Fan. That's the last big thing that comes out this year.
That movie plays on repeat over Thanksgiving. yeah, I mean, I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking about it.
Okay.
Probably, like, if I'll think about it mostly over Thanksgiving, and when I come back from Thanksgiving, then it's a possibility. We're at, like, 75% right now.
You put a lot of thought into this shit.
Okay. I guess, though, it's a wow, dude.
Like, you're contemplating going back to the pipe is what you're doing.
Do I want to hook the heroin back into the vein?
Yeah, Ryan, here's my point of view on it. Mm-hmm. I hit 100 in like the first four, or I hit 100 like Friday night, so it took like 15 hours or something. I kind of like slow rolled the leveling. Okay. I've logged in maybe 8 times since I've played, or since I hit 100 since then.
And from 90?
Yeah, 90 to 100. So I'm just saying, like, I haven't
10 levels? Holy crap.
It was pretty quick, yeah. Well, the leveling's a little bit quicker, but what I'm saying is I haven't logged in more than like 5 or 6 times since it came out last Friday, or maybe the Friday. Yeah, last Friday, I guess. No, 2 Fridays ago.
So you're not that addicted is what you're
so
saying.
Like, I'm not addicted, but I'm trying very, like, I logged in last night and I started like walking around. I'm like, oh shit, I need to go. Oh, motherfucker. I was just like slowly realizing all these little things. So like, I could feel the hooks, but I've stayed not addicted. Like, I'm.
You can stop anytime you want.
I can stop anytime I want. Today's like been worse than any other day, though. But
Neal knows this language.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, we're all we've got our hooks are into us in some form or another.
All I'm saying, Ryan, is that December 2nd the new PvP season starts. So if you wait, then you're gonna be a little bit more fucked than you would be if you started, let's say, tomorrow.
I mean, dude, let's like. In perspective, last time I played WoW, I started my Gladiator grind in the last week and got it in like 2 days. So I'm not that worried about that.
I'm just saying, man. December 2nd.
Okay.
Time's a wasting.
All right.
Or something.
Well, it's something I'm going to be thinking about heavily over Thanksgiving. So we'll see.
I could just see like pensive bearded ass Ryan at his old, family, good old like, Southern family.
It's doing the slow zoom in on Ryan sitting in that chair at the big family dinner, and everyone's talking, just shoveling food. And Ryan's
like,
Iron
Horde.
Should I really do this? Do I want this in my life?
Let's go around the table and talk about things we're thankful for. Ryan, kick us off. Well, I don't know. I can't tell you, honestly.
I'm thankful for Gromash Hellscream. you know, Karen Bloodhoof, among others.
Yeah. Is her name Karen?
It's Karn. It's Karn, something Karn? Like that. He's dead, though.
Yeah. Spoiler alert, I guess.
I mean, that happened like work. I don't know when that
10
happened.
10 years ago?
It happened sometime, a long time ago.
Come on! I've been saving it!
Maybe in the books. I don't know. Someone told me that at BlizzCon. Anyways, Jeff, let's try this again. How are you? Move it up to you, man.
I'm doing good.
Yay! We did it.
No, my Skype's been randomly shutting down. I don't know other people have always had complaints about Skype. I've actually had a pretty clear experience, but lately it's just been like, I didn't even really update anything. You know, your computer goes to sleep and updates, so maybe something there, but it's just like, and you're done. And there's no, I'm not browsing anything. I was just sitting here. You know, you were asking me about my day, so it's like, anyways. So if that happens, guys, I'll be right back. It's not DDoS. It's not internet outage or anything like that. It's literally just my Skype closing. I'll be right back. Been doing well. Just got back from Homestory Cup Germany, which is a lot of fun. Big party over there. And then going to Sweden on Tuesday for DreamHack Winter.
Nice.
In between, played a lot of Warhammer. Been making some YouTube videos, which is kind of a new world for me. That's a lot of fun. And that's that. And the Seahawks won today, so that's really good. They smashed the number one team.
You've been on... I don't care about football. You've been on enough of a movie streak. I haven't been in the movies. All I've seen is... I went and saw that Keanu Reeves movie.
That's great. John Wick. Yeah. Great movie.
I saw Interstellar, by the way.
I have not
Holy
seen it yet.
Shit. It's an experience, dude.
We
go
can't
see
talk
it.
About it yet.
It's fucking awesome.
Did you see it in the IMAX? Did you make that jump?
Yes. 2 thumbs up. Go see that shit.
Maybe I'll see that in...
All right. We'll tone it down, Ryan. Just... JP,
I've never seen Ryan this excited. Ryan doesn't like movies. He actually hates movie experiences.
I am
so
very
for Ryan
snobby.
To be this excited, I'm already kind of excited.
That's good or bad, though, right? It's a guy that doesn't like movies is excited about a movie. It's like, yeah, it's a crackpot.
Well, give your opinion of it, Jeff. What do you think?
It's a great movie. It's enjoyable. But I think for me, Christopher Nolan, when he makes a movie, the expectation is fucking astronomical. Like, the Batman movies, Inception's one of my absolute favorite movies. Like, he's just he's the hottest director right now, as far as I'm concerned. And he wrote and directed it with his brother. It's a great movie.
His brother fucked up?
No, I don't know. It's great. there's just glaring loopholes and just really weird, or not loopholes, plot holes. Excuse me. And there's just kind of weird moments where it's just like, really, that's what it is. It's like, yeah.
There's definitely some stretches.
And they talked about that earlier. They offhand mentioned
Hold on. A movie about space travel
is more believable than fucking Batman. Are you serious right now?
Unbelievable. Yeah.
Okay. Less believable.
Well, I can't say it without spoiling it, but I'd be surprised if you watch this and you're like, oh, that makes perfect sense. They just drove into a fucking black hole, and it was a soft black hole.
So okay. All
anyways.
Right. I'm with you.
But yeah, I went and saw the latest Hunger Games, and it's just right in par with all the other ones. They're pretty decent movies.
Okay.
They're like the pinnacle of that genre, which is like female empowerment romance teeny movies. You know, like the girl is in the middle of a love like quadruped or whatever you want to call it, where there's like nine guys that want to bone her lovingly, but she's just too, you know, strong of a woman to embrace any one of them.
I think that's called a love square. A quadruped would be a
love squared. Let's call it that because it's like to the
30th. I thought you were going to say a quadruped. And I was like, Jeff, what the fuck did you go see?
Well, quadruped's like a type of animal or something like that, but we're all over the place.
Sure, yeah.
It was okay. You know, Jennifer Lawrence is great. And
how was the Game of Thrones girl with the shaved side of her head?
That's where I saw her.
Yeah,
that's
man. Right. I don't know. I can't remember her name, but Natalie Dormer. Boom. There we go.
She's okay. She plays a director in the movie who directs war film.
Oh, that's boring.
And she's like, what's her name? Katniss, tell me how you feel. She's like, I feel terrible. This is horrible. You're going to burn. You'll burn. And it was like, oh, my God. It was weird, though, because there's so much fervor about this movie. There was a couple moments, and I've only experienced this one other time, and it was during the movie The Passion of Christ, where he's getting flogged.
What?
And there's people sobbing in the theater. It was really weird. There's a couple moments where she gave like a speech, and I'm looking there, and I kind of chuckle. I'm like,
wait, people are crying in the theater because of the
sobbing.
Speech?
There was a couple people, yes, like
were they under the age of 14 and female?
It was too dark to confirm, but they were definitely female.
Okay.
And I was all motivated to write a movie review about it, or not write, but do a video, and then I get home and I'm like, nah. I mean, if you saw the other ones, you're gonna see this one.
That's
nothing.
The YouTube video. Then like make the intro, then 5 seconds,
15 seconds.
If you saw the other ones, then you kind of know what you're in for. See you next week.
Yep.
That's all you do. It'd be great. It'd be great. What about Big Hero 6 or whatever? Hero, whatever that movie's called.
Yeah, no, Big Hero 6 was called. I had really high expectations for it, for a cartoon, which I think is my big mistake. It, definitely every scene with the robot is fucking knee-slapping hilarious. Just the personality and the way they do it is so funny. Like it is one of the ways it's introduced is it deploys behind a bed, and it kind of looks at him. It looks at the bed, and then it looks at him. And there's this just awkward, funny pause where it just kind of like slides from the bed because it's too fat. And it takes like a minute for it to get out of there. Then it comes over to him and goes, I am Bromax or whatever the fuck its name is. It was nice. Great. It's pretty okay. Good.
I might go see that. So what you're saying is Interstellar, then Big Sex Hero, and then The Hunger Games?
Yes. Definitely okay. Interstellar above all those. That's the. I mean, you already saw John Wick, which in my opinion is.
Right. I already saw John Wick, which I think I felt like I made the right call.
Yes.
That. Oh, did you see Dumb and Dumber 2? My roommate asked if I wanted to go see it today, and I was just like, no, I'm not interested.
It's all the jokes rehashed, done a little bit worse, and it's strange how old they are. You feel weird watching it. It's still funny. You're going to laugh. I do not regret seeing it, but if you think it's not on par with Dumb and Dumber, and it's quite a bit worse, and it's all the same jokes.
Okay.
Like dream sequence, hot girls getting passed up by them being like, well... You gotta go that way, you know, like that joke again, like everything. It's just the same.
Okay. All right. Well, this has been Jeff's Movie Minute. Tune in next week for more movie news and movie topics. Let's find out what Jen's been up to. Jen, how's it going?
Good, good. Life is good. Work is good. Having fun. What have I done lately? I've been playing a lot of Dota. I've been trying new heroes, trying to diversify my portfolio. I started playing poker because I got chosen to be in the Poker Stars Touch program.
I stream poker. You should come play with us.
I'm down.
They okay. call it the Poker Stars Touch tournament?
Program.
We that call seems- it
so
the-
basically. They pick a bunch of people that are complete noobs at poker from different backgrounds. I'm representing gamers. And then they coach us 1 hour per week with a pro. And then basically at the end there's a tournament with the noobs all together fighting it. And the top, I don't know how many, gets the chance to maybe get sent to Europe for a real poker tournament.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it does touch. I'm still. They shouldn't have gone with touch. That's all I'm saying. Anyways.
Well, it's like the on the tablet.
There you go.
Oh, okay. It still sounds bad.
So I'm really excited about that. I really enjoyed it. I played 1 hour with the pro, and then I spent like 4 hours of my day just playing online, and I just couldn't stop. It was really fun.
Play money, I assume. Can you play? Can you play with real money in Canada? Is that?
Yes. Yes, I can. And they
It's a lawless country, JP. I don't think they actually even have a government.
Well, I know there when I was there, like Moose just walked across the.
Yeah.
It was people riding them. Like there were many wars in some of the smaller areas. Yep. It was nuts.
It's a lawless place.
Yeah. Maple syrup just runs that country.
So yeah, I've been learning poker, and I think I'm going to really like it. I'm having as much fun with it as with, like, Hearthstone, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's about it. Yeah. Poker. New thing.
There you go. Guys, it's a big week here. It's the final show before we never see Neal again because he's getting married.
Oh, my God.
I don't think we'll have a show in between now and the
No, marriage. We got him because he needs this for money, and he can't do 24-hour streams anymore.
Why can't you do 24-hour streams anymore?
Because you're a bitch. When's the last time you did one?
So, Victarion... What's your new character?
Victarion.
Is dead.
It's Victarion. No, it's Victarion.
Last stream was August, and I don't want to say anything else about any future streams.
No comment, he says. See, that's what I'm saying. I'll goad you into it. See, I think you should jump. Like, don't do 150. Do like 240, double or
no,
nothing.
No, 144 would be the theoretical next.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Double it. So 288. Let's just do that.
Just 288.
Was that
if you give
weeks?
Me $10,000 up front, I will try a 288 stream.
Jeff, we could Kickstarter
How
that.
About this? Yeah, you give me $500 if you don't make it.
All right, but if you fund it, you still give me that $10,000 to start.
Jeff, we could do a Kickstarter or an Indiegogo.
Yeah,
I don't know
easy.
What this would be. And it would be watch a man slowly die.
You would die. You realize.
Like, No. Someone did 253?
No
200
way.
Something?
No way.
Is that the record?
It's supposed to be that you like actually start...
Well, you have hallucinations. And, well, yeah. I'm sure.
Let's see. 264.4 hours, 11 days and 24 minutes is the longest someone has stayed awake.
Okay, so they're being tortured in Vietnam, right? Like,
No, it was a volunteer, a 17-year-old high schooler in San Diego in 1964, and they kept him in a sleep lab and monitored the shit out of him.
Or a not sleep
See,
lab, as it
I
were,
think
right?
If you stayed up that long, they would use you in a study and they would watch your stream for years to come.
You know
come.
What I would do? I would be the ultimate asshole. At like 200 plus hours, I would just slowly start like throwing random animals into the room with the guy and just see like what he does. Because maybe he thinks he's hallucinating with them. Maybe he tries to fight the animal. There could be a lot of fun with that.
Maybe he contracts rabies. Like,
I love that happened in the 60s, though, because the other six people they tested died. And it's just like, well, you know, I mean.
Yeah.
It's fine. We paid him $20.
40s, 60s, you know, same thing.
Oh, is it 40s?
47.
Oh, see, that makes even more.
Well, they probably killed the guy after they did that. Because, I mean, that's what happens in the 40s.
Anyways, Neal, how you doing? I think he's still alive, actually.
Is he really?
I can't fucking believe someone stayed up for 11 days.
Oh. That is a lot.
I can't even wrap my head around it. I watching the end of Neal's, 3-day stream was... It was scary. Neal was like... You were like drooling, like in real time. You're like...
Wait, 3-day was like a year ago. The most recent one was 5 days. Thank you very
five
much.
5 days, yeah. And you were just lolling around. And the words that come out of your head were like straight out of chaos.
Yeah.
It was like
straight out of Compton, I would say.
Tree pants dimes. I
Compton
feel like apples.
Is chaos, Ryan. That's
I feel joke. Apples. Yeah, that's true. It's the same thing.
I think you're wildly misrepresenting my stream, sir. I was coherent and cohesion.
I had people.
Almost all the way through. There was a 45-minute section where I was kind of semi-blacking out. But
I stepped away. People tweeted me saying that I had a moral imperative to go to your house and rescue you. And if I watched you die, I would be like an evil person. And I was like,
well, some people don't actually evil. Know what they're talking about. And some people are stupid.
That's true. But for reals, let's get you killed on stream. And then, like, you can write in the will that you got to pay JP and I anyways.
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, we'll do it after you're married, so it's actually she can just do it.
Well, then she would just get everything, which is good for her. So.
That's the whole reason Neil's getting married, so he's going to do a big stream.
One final stream.
One final stream to end them all. There you go. Neil, how are you?
I'm good.
Can we let the man do his shout-outs?
Wedding is 2 weeks from yesterday.
Nice.
And that's exciting. And I actually finally got an engagement ring, which is nice to finally get.
Put that up to the camera. Let me see that.
Oh, that's yours. That's
mine instead of my fiance's.
What's that made out of? It looks like several.
It is made out of wood from the tree in my front yard, the eucalyptus tree where I built my tree fort as a kid, and driftwood from the beach by my house.
That's pretty sick.
Nice.
Yeah, which mirrors the ring that I got for my fiance, which was wood from the manzanita madrone trees that she used to climb as a kid at her house, and the driftwood from where they used to vacation.
I'm gonna be honest, Neil, that sounds kind of like a D&D quest that you both went on, and you had to make that ring. Like,
yeah,
that's
and I got
awesome,
a lot of
though.
Experience for it, and I leveled up, and now I'm getting married.
That's all, right, yeah. Man. That's there all you go.
It's pretty cool.
Congrats.
There's an epic mount joke in there somewhere, but I don't know if I want to go.
Oh
near.
God, your D&D mind is so much better than mine.
That's a wow joke. That's not a
well. Yeah, but there's mounts.
I have actually made the epic mount joke in real life to a female before. It went better than expected.
Is that your current girlfriend, or is that...
No, it was just when I was bullshitting with some girl.
Some girl.
Last week, I had my bachelor party, and I finally saw for the first time Guardians of the Galaxy. But it was outside on a projector on this like wooden wall, so I had to watch it twice after to actually understand.
You don't have to be so edgy to. Is your opinion that you don't like the movie? Let me just ask it straight up.
No, I fucking love the movie.
Okay, good. Thank God, Neil. You're not that.
Who wouldn't
hipster.
Like Guardians of the Galaxy?
There's a chance that you haven't seen Willow, Neil. I can't take you serious.
I saw Willow,
when it
comes to... and it was mediocre.
Oh my God.
Then, granted, I did see it when I was 28.
Didn't we already have this 27? Exact discussion?
Val Kilmer delivers the role of a lifetime.
Yeah. Him and Ron Howard, I mean,
yeah,
you just don't
but
see
that
magic.
Still makes it mediocre.
Him and Ron, good old Ron, like that
Val
magic.
Val Kilmer at
happen.
His best ain't shit, is what Neil's saying.
That's that movie. Name another movie where small
I feel
people
like it's,
are the...
It's, I'll give you
the,
this.
Lord of the Rings.
Well, the no, Hobbit. those are played by adult, full-size people.
Okay.
In Willow...
Peter Dinklage. Or drinking, yeah, or whatever his last name is.
Yeah, he does an amazing job. It's like 30 years later, finally.
Yeah. There's a great many number of films with small people.
No, anyway, I wasn't saying movies with small people. I meant like that they're the primary role.
Oh, the primary character. There was that D&D LARPing movie that he did as well that I'm forgetting of the name of.
Here's a sick reference. I don't know the name of it. What was that? Ewok offshoot movie by LucasArts where these people go to a planet and there's Ewoks and then giant monsters. That would be a close, cool answer. You guys don't know that movie? It's the only other movie with Ewoks in it. The chat's going to know it.
I think it was the Ewok offshoot Return of the Jedi.
No.
What's the name?
Chat's going to answer it. Wait for it.
Turns out Jeff just hallucinated this movie. It doesn't actually exist.
it's real.
You're in day 10 right now, Jeff. 11 hours, 11
Jeff days doesn't straight. Realize he is in the middle of a marathon stream.
The chat is not delivering. They keep
oh,
saying
yeah,
battle.
I was distracting them. Sorry.
Let them focus, JP, please. My God, none of them have said this.
The Ewok Adventure TV movie, 1984.
That's not
IMDb.
It. No, it's a real
know.
Movie.
I don't know.
Wow, you guys, this is the first time chat has not distilled an answer.
The Ewok Adventures. Everyone's spamming that.
I can't be called that.
What do you want it to be called?
I'm going to Google it. Ewok Adventure.
That's it, man.
Wait a second.
You can watch.
Oh, my God, it is.
You can watch the full movie on YouTube, apparently. It's all there.
Well, that is the stupidest damn... Okay, never mind.
Straight to YouTube.
Horrible.
Caravan of Courage, an Ewok Adventure.
Oh my God. I
so,
guess it is.
Where,
it's perfectly
where
timed.
Did the party oh last pick off, leave off?
Before we even start that, Neil is the foremost pizza expert on the show right now. What is your opinion on sliced and not diced, but like sliced tomato pieces on a pizza?
Tomatoes are gross.
Fucking yes. Nailed it. Nailed it. Yes. You win.
You know what you're talking about. Yeah. You
won. I had tomatoes on a taco pizza. Fantastic.
Is a taco a how that's breaking my brain. How do you have a taco pizza?
Taco pizza?
What is a taco pizza?
The fuck's it, a taco pizza?
Is it just ground meat?
No, it's ground beef. They usually put like, you know, kind of the crunchy taco crust type thing in there. Then it's lettuce, tomato, and if you're
wait,
super
hold on.
Awesome,
before we go too far, is the crust like the taco shell like
no,
broken
no, no.
up and just
the
placed
crust
in
is normal pizza crust? But yes, the okay. taco shell is crunched into it,
into you know, the dough into or into the cheese.
No, it's like a topping.
Oh, okay, all right,
and
all right.
It's and then there's different styles. Some places do pizza sauce, but with like salsa mixed into it, which is in my opinion the best. I've also had it where it's kind of like refried beans. For the sauce, nah, that's too taco-y.
I'd be into that.
The
America
the
has
tomato
gone
sauce
too far.
With salsa. Neil, haven't gone far enough.
Is this in like the Mission in SF or what?
No, this is just a style of pizza that's all around the country, man. There's
oh, okay.
Not everyone serves
I thought
it,
this was like a San Franciscan delicacy.
So can I call up like Papa John's and order the bean crust?
No, not crust. So you're getting sidetracked here. It's taco pizza. Oh, but my God. For a while... Pizza Hut had a Philly cheesesteak sandwich pizza.
Oh,
which,
I just Googled
it or
taco
not,
pizza.
Was incredible.
Just looks like a big. Is it a tostada? What is that? Now we're just getting into things that I don't know anything about. Cause all I do is watch Top Chef and think I know what they're about. Anyways.
You just described America.
I've been watching that one where they have like a certain
don't
amount of money.
Don't say Master
and they can,
Chef.
Like, they can like sabotage the other guy and they like. I don't know what it's called.
It doesn't sound like a. That just
they
sounds
run
like
and
a
get the ingredients.
No one can actually cook.
No, dude, it's got that guy on it that you like with the glasses, the chef guy. What's his name?
Alton Brown.
Yes, it's got that guy on
the
there.
Cooking Alton. Show with the chef guy. You know, JP.
I knew.
You got
nailed
it.
I nailed
name.
It.
Yes,
nailed
yeah.
the name. Well, the glasses. Yeah.
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 I think I know who you're talking about. Anne and I watch that show sometimes, and it's
with the money, and they can sabotage and like make them have shitty ingredients and stuff.
My God.
Top Chef
yeah.
is the best
yeah.
cooking show. I'm sorry. Everyone's
okay.
Welcome. It's the best.
I don't like it because either you watch it when you're hungry, in which case it's terrible, or you watch it when you're not hungry, in which case you're bored. It's
I like... watch it right before I go to sleep, so then I dream about food.
Also, you have to take into account that you are on like the super strict diet where you eat the same three things every day. So yes. I imagine that show is a form of torture actually for you.
It's great. I really enjoy it. I'm really a fan.
You're like, cheat day is only 4 days away.
I get ideas from that. I do get ideas from
that's
that.
Awesome.
All right. Let's play.
It's our one.
Yeah. We're seeing in a bit. 3 minute break. That wasn't even that longest intro. It was good.
Yeah,
we're
it was
good.
Fine.
We're good. We haven't spoken to each other in a while. Sorry about that, guys. Anyways, Neil, what's going on in the world of Solum?
So, the party is just outside of Dimreach. In fact, you are on the western side of Dimreach. You are here to find and kill General Kelborn, one of the four Verossi lords. I guess three now that Lady Felicity is dead. This is the city to which all of his troops retreated after the Battle of Ylkvad, which was more of a slaughter, and the feint across the river. The Longborn forces have gathered in Fort Ylkvad and on the other side of the river and are preparing, you know, just kind of massing and getting their shit together, while the Verossi troops have pulled back towards Dimreach and in the ruins between, trying to keep the whatchamacallums, the Longborn soldiers at bay. The party has been sent to Dimreach to find and kill General Longborn in hopes that killing him will cause everyone else to just fall apart and the armies to rout and not end the war, but definitely throw the favor and the momentum in favor of the good side, the good people, the alliance, so to speak. That is where you guys are. I think we last left off. It is evening. Actually past evening. It is nighttime, somewhere around midnight, outside of Dimreach. You guys are on the east side of the city. West side of the city. I'm bad with east and west today, apparently.
Can you give us a little bit of a... I mean, I know. I think you're doing that right now, but what did we do just before this?
We were in the main... Didn't we just arrive here?
You just arrived here. You just got teleported here.
Right?
Previous to this, you...
Rat cleaver and the baby.
Right, you guys had smashed the orb that granted an anti-magic aura around Yulkvad. The Balrog came out, chased you guys away. You went in search of the child who was taken, and you found that the child was actually in the hands of these random weird people in one of the ruins. And then this giant weird rat creature came out, and you guys ran away from him, which was legit, and got yourself teleported to Dimreach.
Okay.
Any further questions? Are we good to go?
Is Roll 20 not loading for anybody else?
Nope. It's working. Damn.
We're here.
Damn it.
It's... Oh, I don't see JP.
Yeah, I'm here. I typed in the chat. Weird. Did you not see that?
Yeah, I saw that. I saw
that. Yeah, then we're good. Your name's just not showing up on the bottom.
Okay.
We're all good. oh, and we also met Monster Varnoosh, who's now a party member.
Correct. Who is a gnome riding a raccoon. War raccoon, and Monsieur Varnoosh, you took your war raccoon with you through the teleport, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
you have
I remember us going back for that, actually.
You have your raccoon, you're mounted upon him, and I believe we left off with you guys trying to find some patrols or something to get uniforms to walk into Dimreach. I believe that is where we left.
Yes. Oh, yeah, we were trying to decide on this big plan.
We did find patrols. Or they ran at us or something like that? Some bullshit happened there, I remember.
It's been a while. I don't recall...
I don't remember that either.
I think you guys actually fought them. I think you guys... The last words were, we're going to look for them. And we left it to this week.
Okay.
All right. So, yeah, I think we start snooping around looking for some guards so we can get their attire and not stand out.
Okay. So you guys are outside. It is nighttime and you are looking around for...
Do we see like a patrol or anything? Like some torch off in the distance on a...
You do not.
Wall or something?
Looking around this area, you don't see any patrols in the region. Although common sense tells you there's going to be fewer patrols behind enemy lines than in front of enemy lines. So,
by that statement, the enemy lines are the opposite side that we're on, right?
Yeah, but they're the opposite side and then, like, many miles that direction.
All right. And would we be under the impression of, if we walked into this town, it's a town, right? It's a proper town. If we walked into this town, that they would be like, you're not Verossi?
Probably. I think the Longborn trapings that you guys kind of give it away.
Is that easily removable?
Yes. I mean, it's just clothing. You can just take it off.
Yeah. I start taking it off and tell everyone that we should remove that while we're on this side.
I guess you're not all wearing Longborn stuff.
Only
Jeff
us three
is wearing
are.
Longborn. You're wearing the trapings of your house, your kingdom.
I'm wearing black armor.
Ryan is that. Yeah, but you have, like, your armor, but you still, like, you are an officer, so you have to have, like, your emblems, and your cloak has your thing, and your tabard has your thing. Like, there's more to it than just armor.
I put it in my fanny pack, then. I take off the Longborn stuff.
Okay. Fanny pack. Backpack, whatever.
Yeah. And then I would say, I'd look at Wojtek, and I'm just like, we should probably go into town. Be very careful. I don't think they will outright fight us, especially if we're not wearing the insignias. We should be okay just to ask around.
Are we still with the baby?
No.
Absolutely not.
Okay.
I had a friend once. His name was Sneaky Tom, and he used to sneak in the towns and go... He'd kill him from the inside out. We should do that.
Is he still alive?
No, he went into a town and died once.
So he's not really that sneaky, so that doesn't sound like a good plan.
He was Sneaky Tom. Now he's dead Tom.
Well, I don't want to be dead Jasper. So... Let's be careful.
Yeah, fucking right. Neither do I.
And I'm like, we should go in. Mr. Varnoosh, can you... I think you're the creature, while quite a nice creature, is going to stand out, if you know what I'm saying.
Yes. Yes, I understand. What do you want us to do with it, then?
Can that thing... Does he have a name?
Yes, Lothar. Mighty steed.
Can we just call it creature from now on? I can't pronounce that.
Lothar?
Creature.
Try Lothar. I can totally try to imitate your accent.
Is his name Lord of the Rings, but sound it out?
Yeah.
Spelled L-O-T-R.
Exactly.
So the Lord of the Rings is with us, is what you're saying.
Yes.
Okay. Can he communicate?
I can't say that name to save my life.
Oh, yes. I can talk to him.
Can he perhaps... Does he have friends in the area that could find information out?
I can also talk to the wild. I can talk to the little creatures around here. But what do you want to do?
Can he talk to them and do some scouting for us while we're in town?
Can they whistle while you work?
Can they what?
Can they whistle while you work? I don't know what that accent was. Like a take our lives. There we go.
Perhaps you could tie him to a tree while we go inside the town.
I look back and I'm just like, you could.
I mean, I can just tell him to stay here. It's going to be okay, I guess. But we have to come back for Lothar. I won't leave my friend behind.
Can he talk to the other forest animals for information?
Can talk to other raccoons, I think. Neil?
You can speak raccoon.
What in the fuck is his name?
But can the raccoon talk to the other
raccoons? It's Lord of the Rings.
I mean, if...
Are you telling me his name is Lord of the Rings?
Yes, raccoons can speak to each other as much as raccoons can speak to each other.
Okay.
You know, it's kind of like hungry, food, burrow, fear, hide, run. Like, you know, they're animals. They're very stupid. They have, like, one intelligence.
They're
just pissed. So basically...
It's not like they're going to, you know, debate the philosophical points of things with you.
Okay, so basically, I'm going to bring Lothar to, like, a slightly remote area in the forest, and then I'm going to tell him to wait for us here and be careful and hide if there's mean creatures approaching.
You tell that to him and he just defecates.
Which translates back as, hungry, go find berries. Or, I go find berries, and he kind of turns around and just starts plodding away. Towards one section of the woods.
And that was the last the party ever saw of Lothar.
Me, 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 I'll be back for you.
Yeah, Lothar eats a poisonous berry and dies.
Okay, so I'll note where I left
guys
him.
Guys, do a pack
so
of ferrets.
Come back to him, but okay. I'm not tying him to anything.
Now that we sent the Lord of the Rings on his journey.
So I'm pretty clear about him staying, Neil. Like,
sure.
The main points are... Stay and hide.
Neo, was that any one of the things you said raccoons understand? Was the stay command?
I mean, that would be understandable. I would say a raccoon has roughly the intelligence of a very stupid dog.
Neil, have you seen Guardians of the Galaxy? You have, so you know you're wrong.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, that's not a raccoon. He doesn't even know what a raccoon is. How could it be a raccoon if he doesn't even know what it is?
That's super
you can't funny. Argue with that logic, JP.
But he is the Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. It's the English translation of his name.
Yeah.
All right, let's find a scouting squad, get their clothes.
Okay.
Okay.
Mr. Varnoosh, how about we break your leg, or at least you pretend, and then you lay in the street, and maybe someone will come.
The Varassi are not very nice. I don't even think they would help
me. I'm just fucking with you. Yeah, fine. We'll do it from the bushes.
Ha 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 ha. I laugh.
And then we go and find bushes outside of the town?
Yeah.
Okay. So you find some spot outside. Yeah, it's still very, very dark. It is cloudy, so no moonlight is shining through even. So pretty much the only light you have is what is given off within the town, which is very, very little light. It's really hard to see. Your vision's limited to a few hundred feet, like at all. And then detail is limited to, 10 feet in front of you. It's the sort of thing where if your friend walks off like 50 feet, you're going to have a hard time finding him without like playing Marco Polo.
I asked Wojtek, can we just lay a torch in the middle of the road?
I suppose that would draw their attention.
Or maybe light something on, start a fire in the center of the road?
Hmm. I do have the ability to make something emanate light to a great distance. That could draw attention as well.
It could.
Oh, actually, if you want me to do this, I could use one of my spells to create some point of interest. I could create anything you want. Humans.
Can you create a beautiful woman who's yes. only wearing the bottom half of her garments?
Oh, yes, I can.
It's a dream come true. How about you do that?
But a human, not a...
I can make it anything you want.
Can you make her glow in the dark?
Can it be a human yes. with an alligator top portion?
Yes. Yes.
All right. Do that, and then make her glow, and have it sing the song of our people.
Yep.
Illusion spells cannot produce light.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Cannot glow.
All right, we'll do some tag teaming. You create this weird thing, and Wojtek, you light it up.
I can do that.
Marius, you stand there and be all pretty, and I'll do the same next to you.
I'm actually, unfortunately, quite unattractive, but...
That's true. He's not that handsome.
I will still stand here.
I believe in you. That's all I say.
All right. Are you sure you want me to create the lizard woman without a top?
Yes, without the top. That's fantastic.
Yep. Little arms, too. Little arms, not long. Just little, like, T-Rex arms.
She will definitely attract attention. I can get
And for a stomach, can she have the bottom side of a bear?
Yes. Yes, she can.
All right. Make it so.
Okay. Just tell me, just so you know, how long can this shit last? Duration special? Until I want to stop, basically?
What spell is it that you're looking at?
Phantasmal Force. I can freaking do it until they come in. Yeah. Until I stop concentrating or they hit it.
So, Neil, we're looking for a spot that's not visible from the wall sentries, obviously, but is, you know, close enough to the town that the patrols...
Are there wall sentries? Do we even...
Yes, there are patrols on the walls.
Okay, yeah. Then we try to do it like Jeff said.
So, how is this all going down, exactly?
She has normal human legs, Neil. The stomach is the back side of a bear. The face is an alligator. Her chest is that of a female woman. And
hairy or unhairy?
Well, Neil...
You got the bear belly, so I'm wondering if the hair extends to the chest or not.
Chest of a woman, so... Okay. You know.
Okay, so super hairy.
And she's dancing.
Like bags of sand, right?
And I'm going to cast light behind her, so it's like a, you know, some kind of light show that's going on.
Okay, and how far from the walls would you like to create this illusion?
Far enough that they can't see from the walls. Like if it's blocked off by trees and
clearly
stuff.
From the walls. Yeah.
Really? Well, no, we're not trying to get
the wall
attention.
No, we don't want the whole village coming in. We basically want anyone who passes through the road to see.
There should
it.
Be troops patrolling outside the wall.
Yeah. Okay, and so you cast these spells. There's light glowing from behind her. And there's illusionary woman. And the rest of you guys then just...
I make her dance, by the way.
She's, we're in
the
all right, so she's watching. Dancing.
Yeah.
And what are you, the rest of you guys, doing?
Hanging out in a bush.
Not fapping, Neil. Get your mind out of the freaking gutter, my God.
Well, so, these things are important to know. I need to know how concentrated you are on your activities.
I'm in a bush. Pretty concentrated on my activity.
Yeah. I'm watching this.
I'm doing it and I'm like, ho, 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 ho. Good thing my wife isn't here.
I love this scene.
It's a good scene.
And then we just wait, I assume.
Yep.
Okay. You guys wait. It doesn't take too long, but after 10, 15 minutes, you hear the rawr sorts of noises from a warg, and an arrow goes sailing through the sky.
They're trying to shoot your alligator lady.
Completely missing the woman by, like, you know, 6 or 7 feet. And thudding, you know, way down the road in the dirt. The arrow clearly came from the direction of the fort. Of the city, I mean. But you're far enough out that it's probably not from the walls.
Can I make her move?
Of course, you can make her do whatever you want. As long as she's within this 400 square foot plus 100 square foot per level area.
Is she corporeal?
Like, she's an illusion. She exists only in your mind.
But will an arrow stick her or will it go through her?
It's going to kill her, I think.
I guess I would know, but I guess I can't even ask that. Never mind.
Well, if it exists in your mind, it wouldn't kill her, right?
we'll just see how it plays through.
I think I can try to make her react to the arrow properly if I only have one thing to focus on.
Yeah, if it's easy enough to pay attention to, you would be able to make her react. You know, if it's just this one thing and it gets hit, you can make it look like it got hit. You can make it do whatever you want. You can make it sprout wings and fly away if you desire.
All right, so I'll make her, like, look scared and start running a bit, but not too far.
Running where?
Like, a little bit further down from us so that they start chasing her and pass us, basically.
Run her towards us.
So she starts running down the road away from the
just
city.
I want to be clear with my intention. Basically, I'm trying to make her run in a way that if they would follow her, it would be a flank for us.
Right, right. So she's running down the road away from town. If they come down the road, you guys are on the side of the road, you would be on their side.
Yeah.
Yeah, very. Yeah, I get it. So she takes off, and you hear the roar, roar again. And soon enough, you hear the soft padding of animal feet on packed dirt. And you see one orc with a spear and a bow slung over his shoulder, but the spear's in hand, riding on a warg trying to run after this creature.
Do we see...
Does he have the outfit?
It does not have the clothes that we need.
I mean, he's wearing the clothes of Rossi and whatnot, but it's only one.
I think I can get him to get his friends and bring him out here.
Okay.
Bring him close. Or is he within casting range, Neil?
Of what spell?
How close are we? Let's go that way.
You guys see him. You don't actually get that much time notice to see him because it's really fucking dark and the light spell only extends so far. So by the time you get a good view of him, he is only like 40 or 50 feet from you.
And he's away from the wall by quite a distance, right?
You guys are some 100 feet away from the wall.
I go, hey, emo man, draw your bow. And if this doesn't work, put an arrow between his eyes. We need not alert the forces.
And I stand up, and my eyes glow, and I extend my hand at him, and I say, and I cast Dictate on him.
And okay, I say, let's roll initiative then.
Damn it.
Let's just all roll initiative.
Or solo.
Why can't I do this before initiative, Neil?
Because you're declaring actions, and Ryan's declaring actions, and I want to see how you guys, who goes in what order. And whoever was first can, of course, say, I want to wait until after so-and-so's thing goes off. So if you want to do that, that's fine.
But he doesn't know that he's in it.
Right. This is like a surprise action.
Yeah. I'm not standing up and going, I am here, and now I cast my spell. I'm just casting my spell.
Just between the two of you guys is what the initiative is
for. Okay.
Unless you guys want to say, like, I go first, don't worry about it.
Well, he's going first. I will.
Okay, cool.
If
that's
I
fine.
Better,
don't worry
I
about the
my...
initiative.
Yes.
So you stand up. You stand up and start casting Dictate at him. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's not. There we go. Dictate. Okay. Dictate goes off. And he gets a save versus spell. And Ryan, you're standing up and notching your bow. Oh, critical fail on his save versus death.
Save versus spell?
Yes, that thing.
I stand up, I extend my hand, my eyes are glowing, and I say, we have lots of money and our friends. Bring a patrol to gather it.
He slows to a stop, turns to face you. Du-du-du-du-du. Hold on, give me one second here. Oh, God, where is that book? Hold on. Sorry. I didn't have the page open already. O-R-C. Nope, that's not orc. Here we go. Yeah, okay. The orc slows to a stop and stares at you. Ryan, are you making an action?
I am holding my action, which means my bow is strong and
hold
ready.
Hold your fire.
But
hold
I'm not shooting yet.
The orc turns to face you, as I said before, kind of just looks at you for a moment and then grunts and turns around and starts riding back towards the town.
I'm pretty sure it worked. If it didn't, there should be an army here any moment. So it should be. We'll find out in a second, I guess. Mr. Varnoosh.
I will keep the lady to entertain us.
Can you make her 45 feet tall and dense?
Yes. So
dictate lasts one round per level. What level are you, Wojtek?
Seven.
Okay, so for 7 minutes, he will be under the effect of this spell.
I make the woman grow.
It should last just long enough for him to get to a patrol and say, there's friends over here with free money. Come with me.
I make her throw money around. Fake money.
When it wears off, do they
retain like this.
All knowledge? Like, I've just been duped and this guy's...
I mean, they know the things that have happened to them. They're just no longer under the effects of the spell. So, So he turns around and rides back. You guys are all kind of waiting while the strange female-ish creature is standing around dancing, tossing money everywhere. that falls to the ground.
Can I keep this concentration up and hide in shadows since we're in the woods?
Yes.
Okay, I'm doing that.
Well, you can't. So part of hiding in shadows is there actually has to be a shadow to hide in. Mm. If everything is dark, you can't hide in shadows because hide in shadows relies on the difference between light and dark to keep yourself hidden.
Okay, well, I hide.
Okay, you hide. Cool. Cool.
You know, are we about to have a fight?
No.
Okay.
Maybe. I don't know. I never know if you guys are going to have a fight. It really depends on what you guys
are doing.
I guess
that's kind of a stupid question, yeah. What I'm saying is, should we take a break?
If this is a good break point, then this is a good... Then yes, this is acceptable.
Okay. But before we go to the break, how many people are riding back to the spot where we're at? Can we even tell that? Because it's dark
out. So, hold on, if you guys are... And the warg's movement rate is... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you see a dozen orcs on wargs riding up into this well-lit area and kind of stopping, looking around. The leader points back towards you guys are, which is just a little bit of ways from the lit area, and they walk out of the light into the darkness.
How much time has passed, Neil?
It's hard to tell. Give me an intelligence check.
Fantastic. What's my intelligence? Someone
13.
13. I'm pretty smart. D20 plus 13. 21.
It's been about 5 or 6 minutes.
All right. This should have worked. They believe it. And I stand up and I go, over here, boys. The money's right here.
That's a good time to take a break. So we'll do that. And we'll come back. I can't wait to read the comments saying, they only played for 15 minutes. That's true. We did only play for 15 minutes. And we'll be back with more actual roleplay right after this. We'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching.